First, I'd like to acknowledge and thank Madame Monica, the First Lady of Namibia, and the Ambassador of Miracle More Than a Mother for the great passion I have seen these 2 days. And actually, from the minute we met until now, I've seen a lot of progress. So thank you very much. I think that we are going to do a huge impact and significant impact in the country with your support. Thank you very much. Secondly, just to let you know that when we had the meeting yesterday, everything was clear to us that there is certain things you needed to change, like the narrative, like you said. There is lack of information, so we need to improve access to information about prevention, about male infertility. It means that it takes two to have a child. It's not only the mother or the woman who is responsible for children. And infertility has nothing to do with sexuality or your performance as husband and wife. This is very important for men specifically, because they take it as a taboo that maybe he's not a man enough, or he's not doing his job as a husband, or sexually he's not performing well. It has nothing to do with it, because you can see a father of 10 sons and he is not sexually strong, and the opposite. So we have to emphasize on that, male infertility, prevention. And then there is a lot of technologies around for management. That's why we want to improve access to health by training the local experts, the local fertility experts in the country. So the couple who seek help, they can maybe need help of small intervention, like 5 days intervention, and the delaying of this intervention because there is no attention of a healthcare provider who specialized in this, it might complicate the subject. So having these local experts around, they will improve very much the impact, or the impact we would like to have, the support for the infertile couple or the childless couple, or the couple who's seeking to have children, because they might only, as I said, need maybe a course of antibiotic, a course of tablet. And of course, raising awareness for prevention and raising awareness of breaking the stigma of infertility. And hence, these take us to change the mindset, the culture shift we want to create. And we thought that art and media is a very good and critical partner to make any community culture shift. Media enter every house. Media, if they understand the topic properly and normalize the issue, so it become like a normal thing, like diabetes, like hypertension, like you remember HIV long time ago when it was a taboo and now everyone talks about it normally. So media, by the training we are going to provide, and the media recognition award, and the fashion award, and the filmmaking award, all these things will sensitize the community, be the voice of the voiceless, break the silence, make everyone feel that they are not alone, and say to the community, to the people, they think that it is okay to insult others, to discriminate others for something they never had any control over, it's okay. Because I believe that not everyone is evil, or not people are not evil by nature. They don't really mean to hurt people and to insult them and to break their soul. To break their soul. They don't mean that. But when they know that they're doing this, it is more criminal than killing someone, to break someone's soul, to make him feel that he's a shame, he's not worthless, he has no values, he has to hide, he has no life. And we are the one who's making others feel this way. When we know it's incorrect, I think we're going to stop it. I'm sure. And here is our role as the advocacy of Her Excellency the First Lady, the champions of the healthcare providers we train, the media we are going to train, the art, the singers, the filmmakers, all these people will be talking every day. And within maybe a few years, 2-3 years, these things which we think that is incorrect will change. The narrative will change. And people will think that this is your own business. If you want to have a child, it's your own business. Nothing to blame you. It's nothing wrong you have done. There is no myth. And if you have a child, it's okay also. We are going to be happy for you. So this is, I think, the plan. And of course, any new ideas, we are going to take it forward. There is certain things, of course, you can do when you are, since young ages, from young age to to prevent, but to maintain your fertility aspect. Regular checkup, for example, there are small things like chlamydia and the small infection from a lack of hygiene can cause infection if it's not treated. They have no symptoms. If it is not treated early enough, it can go further and spoil their reproductive health. Of course, exposure to toxins, pesticides, paint, and all this also can affect the infertility of men and women. Other things like eating healthy, healthy balance, also keeping your weight balanced, like not very underweight or overweight. This also very important. Exercise regularly. All these things we prevent the communicable, non-communicable diseases like diabetes and hypertension also affect infertility or fertility. This is for women and for men. There is leaflets we produce for prevention of infertility for male and women. And we are going to distribute it, and it will be on our website and Her Excellency also social media and website, so everyone can have access to this. And we also going to produce together something else about the myth buster, busters or busting, yes, busting. So all these myth theories that people are taking forward and believe in it, we are going to address it also on these materials.